The information and opinions expressed in this podcast do not necessarily reflect those of ASRM and its affiliates. These podcasts are provided as a source of general information and are not a substitute for consultation with a physician.
Welcome to ASRM Today, a podcast that takes a deeper dive into the current topics in reproductive medicine.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Hayes, your host for this episode of ASRM Today. On this program, we're talking with Dr. Eve Feinberg about the recently issued joint statement produced by IFFS, ESHRA, and ASRM on the global COVID-19 pandemic. Dr. Feinberg is the president for the Society for Reproductive Endocrinology and Infertility and an associate editor for the Journal of Fertility and Sterility. She sits on the executive board of both the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, as well as the American Society for Reproductive Medicine. Dr. Feinberg, welcome to the program today.
Thank you so much for having me.
So for listeners who might not know, who are IFFS, ESHRA, and ASRM?
Well, I'll start with ASRM since that's our home organization, and that stands for the American Society for Reproductive Medicine. And we are a society that serves lots of different members, from physicians to urologists, mental health professionals, and embryologists, and basically everybody in the reproductive space within the United States. We also have many members outside of the United States, and we're a growing global organization as well. ESHRA is the European Society for Human Reproduction and Embryology, and contains a lot of physicians and healthcare workers and mental health professionals throughout the world who are also interested in reproduction. And IFFS is the International Federation of Fertility Societies and also another global organization in the fertility arena. When the pandemic initially started, each one of the organizations was operating independently to come up with best practice recommendations for each of our own societies. The ASRM aggregated a COVID-19 task force, and we came out with our first set of recommendations March 17th and committed to our membership every 2 weeks in the initial part of the pandemic that we would meet and we would update the recommendations. IFFS and ESHRA have similarly come up with their own set of recommendations. And what's interesting is the three societies were working independently, but all arrived more or less at the same point in the beginning part of the pandemic, when the death toll was rapidly rising and much was unknown. The three societies independently recommended a temporary pause on fertility treatments. Fast forward 5 weeks later, it seemed like the pandemic was stabilizing. Each society was reconvening and coming up with plans for how to resume fertility care. And each society, within days of each other, released similar recommendations on the resumption of fertility care. Now, the issues in the U.S. As well as globally were marked from both a mental health perspective as well as a patient advocacy perspective. And we felt very strongly, independently as our own society, as well as nationally and globally, that infertility is a medical disease. And the three societies got together to really affirm this concept, to say that infertility is a serious medical disease. It is timely, it is important, and even in the worst of times, care should be continued. And so there were two representatives from each society we met, we convened, and we came up with what we thought was a really strong position statement from our respective societies.
What are the top three takeaways from this particular statement?
The top three takeaway points are really, first and foremost, that human reproduction is an essential right, and human reproduction does not discriminate based on sexuality, based on gender, based on color. And I think in light of recent events, I think that our statement was quite timely in that all humans have the right to reproduce. That was the first takeaway point. The second takeaway point is that infertility is a disease and it should be treated as a disease. It is progressive, it is serious, it has profound implications for our patients, both medically and from a mental health perspective. The third takeaway point is that infertility treatment is essential even in times of a pandemic, and that with declining birth rates that many countries are seeing over time, it becomes even more essential during tough times for our country and tough times globally to continue to allow patients to continue to reproduce and replenish the population effectively.
As these three groups have come together for this, were there any controversies in creating the document?
Not at all. Actually, it was a lovely and smooth process. We sat around at the Zoom table, so to speak, and really hammered out our thoughts. Alan Penzias was tremendously instrumental in the initial draft, put the thoughts on paper that we could all marinate. And we really sat around and said, aha, yes, this is exactly what we need to think about. And we had a thought-provoking conversation. I think everybody was incredibly collegial and in agreement. And it was amazing to see specialists from other countries who were just so like-minded in their care for their patients and their advocacy for their patients. And I will say advocacy for their fellow physicians as well, reaffirming that what we do is incredibly important.
Do you see, since this was such a collegial process, is there future possibilities of these three groups working together again in this type of collaboration?
I hope so. I think that there's a huge need for our field to come together. There's a huge need, not just in the U.S., but also globally. And there are multiple issues pertaining to human reproduction on a global scale. And I think that it was amazing to see just the like-mindedness of the group. And I think that ASRM in and of itself is a powerful organization. But when you add in other fertility societies into the mix representing not just the U.S., but really the world, it becomes that much more of a thought leader. And I'd like to see many more discussions and conversations and even educational conferences be more global in our future.
What are the top takeaways then that people will get from this statement?
I think the first is that human reproduction is essential, that we have a biological drive to reproduce. And taking away all politics, I think every human being has that drive to reproduce. I think it doesn't matter whether you define yourself as male or female, or somewhere in between, that right to have a child is essential. I think the same goes for race, that there should be no discrimination based on race as to somebody's right to have a baby. I think the same holds true for socioeconomics. And I think that infertility is the great equalizer, unfortunately. It's equally prevalent in everyone. It doesn't discriminate by race, by sex, by gender, or by socioeconomics or by country of origin. And so I think first and foremost, the big takeaway point is that there is a right to reproduction and that right is universal.
Today, I've had the absolute pleasure of speaking with Dr. Eve Feinberg about the recently issued joint statement produced by IFFS, ESHRA, and ASRM on the global COVID-19 pandemic. Dr. Feinberg, thank you so much for speaking with us today.
Thank you so much, Jeff, and thanks everyone for listening.
This concludes this episode of ASRM Today. For show notes, other information, and discussions, go to asrmtoday.org.